Sean Van Houten.
Our body composed of cells, and the programs in the cell is genes, and according to how the genes work, our life works, and the controller of the genes is God. We have talked about this scientifically so far. Let's get into more Bible and spirit prophecy. What we have talked so far, let's go into spirit prophecy. We have just watched a video clip. Like we have watched, this world said, eat this food and eat that food. Yeah, food is very critical, very important. Yeah, we cannot deny this. Now, methyl is influenced by food, but that we don't know how this methyl works. Humans cannot control this methyl, which genes should be attached by this methyl. Now, when we take vegetables, and then we have this folic acid, and this folic acid goes to this certain genes, and on a certain genes will be turned off or turned on later on, and then we will get normal and things. And now this methyl is glorified by us, or the food is glorified by us, not the controller, God. So those who have this methyl will be sold well. Now, this kind of way of thinking, this worldly way of thinking, is all spread. We don't acknowledge God in our daily life. Instead, we acknowledge God in a religious way. We only accept God in the church or religious way. Theologically, we only accept Jehovah God. But the digestion system, and then those turning off and turning on those genes, we don't acknowledge God in that sense. We need to be out of this. That's the second angel's message. God does everything in our lives. We need to seek His will in all we do. We're just like, that's just science, that's not theology. That is spiritualism. Definitely that's spiritualism. So the first angel's message and the second angel's message, if we only think limitedly with a denominational way, let's say like you worship on Sunday, but then now you worship on Sabbath, now you're out of this Babylon. It's not like that. The way of thinking should be changed. Yeah, we got this sign, God's sign on our head already. Well, by the way, genetically, because of this social phenomena, we have this kind of idea. Now, when the time comes, When the time comes, we will have this separate way to choose. You have to choose which way to go. Now here, when I say forehead, it's like the way of thinking. It's the way of thinking. In our way of thinking, we have this worldly thinking. So, you know, that's why our denomination made this new start. And they say, if you practice new start, you will get normal. That's what we teach. We teach, like, if you have vegetarian diet, you will get better. So then, what makes you get better? That's vegetarian diet. This kind of way of thinking, that's the worldly thinking. That's the Babylonian thinking, dualistic thinking. The way of beasts thinking. We should be free from this. It's not all about food. You know those new start elements? What are those elements? What do they do? According to the classes, I said, only God, only the life wave will restore our genes. Then what is that new start? You know, the most important thing in New Star, that's the last word, T. It means a trust in God, a trust in God's life wave. Now, other seven elements, what are they? Now, let's say we have like new start, eight letters. So T is just 1/8. No, it's not like that. Actually, the T is everything. But N-E-W-S-T-A-R, those are kind of the infrastructure. Those new stars should be ready. That's the infrastructure. Now this is the bean. What is that? That's an embryo. That's an eye. What is that eye? You say the eye is life, then eye is God? No, it's not like that. That the eye of the seed is a program to keep this being live. That's the gene, actually. And so one being falls into the ground, and now roots out, roots down, and then has stems, and then leaves, and then flowers, and then have fruits. You know, this bean will prosper, will live and prosper. That program is in this eye, an embryo. Now, that gene is turned off totally right now in this state. Now, there in the eye, the embryo, there are genes. When I was 7, like 60 years ago, yeah, we didn't have a lot of food. Everybody was starving. Well, our snacking was like the steamed potato or just the beans, baked beans. So I had a lot of beans in my pocket and the drawer. And I was looking at this bean. This bean looked very special to me. Why? It's because in my pocket, it didn't grow. It didn't sprout. Not in the drawer. But the bean was planted in the ground. It started to sprout. I think the bean knows its location. My uncle at that time, by the way, he was very smart, very good student. He was the top student in number one university in Korea. He was very smart. He knew everything. So whenever I asked him a question, he answered all. So I said, "Uncle, how did this bean know where it was?" My uncle didn't know it. So, wow, you don't know this? Wow. My uncle, he was very proud because he knows everything. He thought he knew everything. So when I was young, I asked him many questions. I asked him about the light, sunlight, and the wind, and everything. So I think because of my uncle, thanks to my uncle, I asked him many questions, and he enlarged my world. So I asked him this question I didn't know. I asked him, how does this bean know where it was? Well, this question is not a serious question, but then my uncle couldn't answer, so he was hurt. His pride was hurt. So my uncle said, well, I'll look it up in the book, and I will search, and then I'll tell you, dear. After a week, my uncle didn't answer. So I went to him and I said, "Uncle, so you have no answer for that question?" And then my uncle, "It's not in the book, dear." Of course it's not in the book. Of course it's not supposed to be in the book. No, this bean, it doesn't know. It can't know where it is. Well, there is no like ego or the thing. It's just a material. It's a protein and DNA thing. The substance doesn't know where it is because it doesn't know itself. Now this bean is planted, and then the roots will be spread. That's the number one gene. When the number one gene is turned on, then they make the roots. And that's the leaf. And that's the stem. That's the branch. That's the leaf. Those genes will all be turned on. That's the flower gene working, and that's the fruit gene turned on. When I draw this picture and the seminar, people laugh. I don't know why people laugh, but they laugh. I don't know why, but they laugh anyway. Well, you guys don't laugh. That's number one, root genes. Number two, the sprout. And the three stem, and the four branch, and five leaf, and six flower, and seven fruit. Well, according to the time, in order, those genes should be turned on. No, those meth. So that the methyl with the we learned. No, God will send His Spirit well, and will turn on those genes in order. If methyl is attached to the genes, those genes will not be turned on. So you know God will have to take a hard look, and oh, okay, the bean is well planted, and then you know He works in order. That's how God works. Sounds like it's not theological, hey? Sister White said, every day, every moment, God takes care of even just the grass on the ground. Sister White is a wonderful biotheologian. She has different concept of theology. It's not just academic theology. Maybe academically, somebody can laugh at it. This bean should be planted in the ground. Well, to make these genes be turned on, infrastructure should be ready. We need to have this infrastructure should be ready. Now the beans in my pocket, they have no infrastructure. So God doesn't have to send this life wave to turn on all these genes because they don't need it. Well, God knows where these beans are. It doesn't sound it's academic. Anyways, when this bean is planted in the ground, it'll be provided nutritionally. That's N. Well, God doesn't work just because it has nutrition. Well, the water should be added. Now, nutrition and water, they're not all. It needs the sunlight. You know, sunlight is photosynthesis working, but also it'll make the genes turned on as well. So that's S. Not all those three enough. Not all those three are enough. Those nutrition and water and sunlight, they all should be. Enough, but not too much. They need temperance. Not too much of nutrition, not too much of water, not too much of sunshine. It needs temperance. And also it needs air, not in the vacuum state. So the bean needs this NWSTA program. And then the beans will grow and then prosper. It will grow and multiply. Then every step, every process, life wave should come and turn on those genes. So those attached methyl should be detached to turn the gene on. Somehow, scientists say that human beings will have this control over this methyl to attach and detach. They said the time will come. But to make this possible, it's got to be a supernatural power level. In the level of supernatural power, there can be healing. You know, Satan can control that methyl with his wave. It's like, who is controlling? That's the key point. Who is controlling? That's the key point. Well, who should be the question? But then instead of who is healing, we say what treats our disease. For us, that is important. Our question is what? We don't acknowledge God in all we do. Now, infrastructure, is NWSTA for this bean to grow and multiply. Now, here in our infrastructure, let's take out nutrition, let's take out the sunlight, just a little bit of sunlight, and then no ground. Then what happens to this bean? This bean will be the sprout, the vegetables that we eat. Why? Because those genes which were supposed to be on, they're all turned off. Because they're not planted, no nutrition, then no sunlight, no flower, no branch, no stems, nothing. Because it's not planted in the ground. Well, God knew then that, well, if this has flowers, what environmental condition, which is infrastructure, is not ready for this bean, well, it's not going to grow and multiply as it was supposed to be. So where the infrastructure is well equipped, then God turns on all those genes and say, okay, you grow and multiply. And so, okay, you go to this part and that part. Yeah, even though this bean wants to have flowers and fruits, but the infrastructure is not ready for this. So infrastructure is very important. Before I say infrastructure condition, and then some people say, well, then our salvation is conditional? Some people ask me that question. Wow, theology that sometimes gives us headache. Because condition, the word, really gives people a question. So I was thinking of this condition, the word condition, more seriously. So I decided not to use condition, the word condition. If I continue using this word condition, then they'll have a lot of questions.
So
Because, you know, there's this word, the conditional salvation. It's not like that.
Under this condition, I will agree with you. 이러한 조건 아래서 당신과 내가 의견을 내가 동의한다. 이런 건데.
Well, you know, actually, there are two definitions of this condition, the word. When we talk about righteousness by faith, there's no condition. In that sense, you know, people can have trouble understanding this. Now, when we say there's no condition, what does that mean, that condition? When I say, you know, we need this condition, then what kind of condition does it mean? Let's say there are two definitions. Now, let's say, if you give me $500, I'll sleep with you. It's like the condition. In that condition, under this condition, this condition that I talked about, that I just said, doesn't exist in the Bible. Go for that word condition on the computer, you won't find it. The Bible doesn't have this kind of condition. Well, let's say, then condition that are what I talked about is, what is that? It's like this. It's like this. Now, let's say this person is very thirsty. So I said, he said, oh, Dr. Lee, I'm so thirsty and thirsty. So please do something. So I said, well, okay, this is a water bottle. There's condition. If you take this water bottle and open the lid and drink, you will not get thirst. Well, the first example that I gave you, like the, if you give me $500, well, that's a totally different condition. Well, terminology and definition is very complicated in theology. Because, yeah, so when I say condition, people only think about only one condition. First condition that is like $500, that condition is like the reward. That kind of a rewarding condition doesn't exist in the Bible. In the salvation, that kind of condition doesn't exist. But here, it's like, you take and you drink. If you take and when you drink. Well, theologically, this condition, the word, has quite important meaning. So if you, yeah, it's not rewarding, okay? It's not a rewarding condition. This, I want to say prerequisite. Instead of using the word condition, I would say prerequisite. Under that prerequisite, we're confused by this word. So let's just not use this word condition, prerequisite instead. Let's use it. So if the infrastructure is not ready, God cannot work on it. You know, there is no sun rays. Leaves are not necessary to be grown. No, those vegetables sprout, they can grow a little bit, but they cannot be the bean plants. It's same with the animals. Animals, they move, so they need this word exercise, E. You know, exercise, people say, well, exercise is good for the health, but this is wrong. If you don't exercise, there's going to be a lot of damage in you. You don't feel it, but then you will have a lot of damage inside of your body. Turning off and turning on genes, those activities will be reduced. You don't recognize this. You should exercise. It's like the necessity. It's not the necessary, but exercise is necessity. That's the prerequisite. It's not because we exercise and we eat vegetables, you're good, and I will turn your genes on. It's not like that kind of rewarding condition. It's the, just the infrastructure. When I talk about this New Start message, people think it's the righteousness by work. So some pastors, they don't count this health message as the gospel. They don't take this health message as a very important gospel, because they think it's like the condition, and it's like the righteousness by work. But it's not. When righteousness by faith comes, you know, people got casual with Sabbath keeping. It's not like if you keep the Sabbath, it's not the condition. It's not that kind of rewarding condition. In Sabbath, there is life. Let's say the water bottle is life. Then I give you this life and to drink it. It's not a rewarding condition. Well, yeah, I'm sure we will spread this gospel. If you don't keep the Sabbath, there is no life. This message, like the extreme message, will have to be proclaimed. But because we don't have this concrete, solid idea about the Sabbath, we're not in that state yet. We only think about Sabbath is just a Saturday. When people talk about Sabbath is the legalistic, then we just have no words to say. But when you are sure about this Sabbath as life, it'll be different. Now this is Sabbath. Now you take it and drink it and you will quench your thirst. Is that the condition? Well, Satan used this word condition in a very subtle way, and Satan confuses us with this word condition. You know, I practice New Start, and I, of course, well, I think I know the righteousness by faith, but the one word condition, this word condition, can destroy everything, can destroy the true meaning of Sabbath. It's not about the condition, the rewarding condition. You have to separate this word. from condition and pre-requisition. So if you don't exercise, you will lose a lot. It's not just if you don't exercise. It's not just exercise is good for your health. Exercise is necessity. It's infrastructure. It's not like if you exercise, that's not a condition. Remember this. Now you exercise and you get tired and you need rest. Animals, they practice New Star program. You know, those animals at the zoo, you know, they need to run and they need to be very active, but in the zoo, they don't really exercise. Do you know what happened to them then? Then there is no multiply. You know, the guys, you know, the male animals, they go to the female one. They're not interested in women. I mean, the female animals. Why? Because those genes are all turned off. If you exercise, you will get pregnant. It's not like that. You have to make sure the word condition. Definition of the word condition. When you exercise, God's life wave can work in you correctly, so you're ready to grow and multiply. You know, theology, according to the word, like the one word, it depends. You cannot figure out with theology with one word. You cannot decide theology with one word. People will know they're in the right track by listening to the Holy Spirit. Those who don't know about theology, but they will still know they're in the right track, is because of the Holy Spirit whispering in their ears. Now animals, they practice New Start. And the human beings now, the human beings, we need to practice New Start with T at the end. Why do we need this T? Animals don't need this trust, but then we human beings need trust. Why is that? It is related to the free will. With our free will, we have to decide. It's not demanding, it's not forcing. You have to decide. When you decided to do the New Start, you have to have trust. You need to have trust. You should have trust to practice New Start. But a lot of times, we teach this New Start as You Star. It's like the T, when they talk about T, it's like the pray. It's like the 1/8 part. But actually, T is everything. It's not about 1/8 of New Start. We have to trust life wave of God. However, even though we practice only New Star without T, a lot of people get normal. And that's why people say vegetarian diet will do everything. People can conclude that kind of things. Well, me, I say we need to be joyful as you read the Bible and we need to trust in the Lord. But you know, even without the Bible, without knowing God, they practice the New Start without tea. But if they practice New Start, you know, sometimes they get better. Actually, many times people get better by practicing New Start. If you have experienced, you will know that if you practice New Start, you will feel much, much better. Why is that? Even though you have no tea, you will feel better. Why? You know, let's say life wave from God is 100%. Let's say usually we receive 20%, we receive. If we receive 100%, yeah, we'll become like a great figure. Like we understand everything whenever we read the Bible. We will become like Jesus. Our character will be changed and everything. Yeah, we will be like that if we receive 100% of life wave. But you know, sometimes we get angry and upset and so forth. So we only receive 20% of life wave, let's say. Even that with that 20%, we're still healthy. But when something miserable things happen and you got really upset or angry or depressed, and then those 20% even got reduced, decreased. So it got into lower into 5%. And then you started to eat meat, drink, and then you don't pray. And your lifestyle got worse because of that terrible things. Your infrastructure got all damaged and destroyed. Now, 20% of life way you received, usually, you know, let's say you didn't go to church at the time anyway. So you got sick. But then without knowing God, those miserable things were all served out, and then now you go back to those infrastructure in a right way, and then you also have those 20% of life way back, then you get better again. It means God's grace is abundant. You need to explain how they got well without knowing God even. If you don't explain, their conclusion will be like, brown rice is good. Vegetarian diet is good. That will be their conclusion. I had one evangelistic meeting in Seoul area. You know, when I had that seminar, you know, people gathered and, oh, there's Dr. Lee, I want to listen to him. So, you know, we had like three times of busy session every day. Anyways, I went to J area to have this seminar. There's a person who looks very healthy. He came into the seminar. So I asked him, oh, you look very healthy, and what brought you here? He said, well, I'm a cancer patient. He didn't, well, you don't look like you're a cancer patient. And he said, well, I got better. And I said, oh, really? Do you go to church? And he said, well, no, I don't go to church. And I asked, how did you get well? And he said, well, I was fortunate. I was lucky. And I said, what kind of luck did you have? And he said, well, I had a good doctor. And he said, well, this doctor is from which and which hospital, and nice hospital, and he took care of me really well, and that's why I got better. So wherever he goes, he always talks about that so-and-so hospital and so-and-so doctor. Because of that doctor, I got better. It's like that way. But you know, cancer cannot be cured 100%. Why? Because cancer cell grows daily in our body. It's just a temporary thing. Well, because I know this one, so I said, it can't be the luck. But he said, well, I was lucky. And I said, well, I don't think so. So I asked again. I said, is there any change in your life after you got a cancer? He said, oh yeah, of course. I changed my lifestyle. You know, I was very greedy in money. I have a lot of business. I was very busy and I drank a lot. And I thought I got sick because of that. So I wrapped up all the business because I have enough money. So I just wrapped up all the business. And I decided not to be greedy. What does that mean, everyone? But this guy still, this man still believes that the doctor did something. And I asked him another question. Is there any difference? And this man said, well, people said vegetarian diet is good, so I have this vegetarian diet. So I said, oh, really? Any difference? Something that you do that you didn't do before? He said, well, I go hiking. Well, he was practicing basically new star. Without tea, yeah, he got better. Remember those 20% of God's life wave and the infrastructure, seven infrastructures? It's not just the luck. It's not just about food. But if you have good, well-equipped infrastructure, God is very happy and thankful. Oh no, you're having good nutrition and exercise and water and temperance and air and rest and thank you. If you don't come to church, you get well. That person got cured because of the life wave. But even so, the world says nutrition make the people change and get well. Well, if you don't know biotheology, how can you explain it to these kind of people? You know, life way is the most important thing. The power of the Holy Spirit and the power of God's healing, that should be the number one. If you put those things in the middle and then explain everything, it'll be easier. If you practice on the new star, your character won't be changed or transformed. You will not have new hope, no faith. Now here the T is a very critical T. T, let's say, even though you don't get normal, you're still sick, and maybe you can die because of your sick. But if you still trust, that is more precious. Now, New Start program, it's not about getting better, but even though you don't get well, but if you trust, if you believe in the truth, you're still happy. And then some patients say, Dr. Lee, even though I don't get well, I am very happy because I found Jesus and accepted Jesus. And I said, you know, there are some diseases that can be healed. Like infrastructure is wonderful. You believe in trust. You believe in God. You have this trust and everything. But then there are some cases that cannot be healed. Biologically. Why is that? Even though that person has wonderful infrastructure and trusts, but then that person cannot get healed. Why is that? This person won the victory over this faith and trust. This person is not going to say goodbye to God just because he doesn't get healed. Let's say I am that kind of person. I have this good infrastructure and 100% trust God, and let's say I received the power of the Holy Spirit, but I don't get well. Let's say, you know, I cannot get sick, and if I get sick, even though I get sick, I will get well. Let's say I am that person. You know, I have good relationship with God. I won't get sick. Let's suppose that way. But you know, I can get sick. Why? Why? Can you tell me specifically? Jesus said, Simon, Simon, Satan tried to tempt you. Satan requested, Satan demanded you. Jesus says, Simon, Satan has requested you. What does that mean? This is very, very important. Satan requested, Satan demanded you, Simon. Satan has demanded you, and I accepted that request. Because of that, you will deny me three times before.
베드로는 뭐라 그래요? 저는 절대로 부인하지.
The crow.
응.
The cock crows. And then Peter said, "No, I won't betray you, Jesus." That's what the Peter said. But if Jesus withdraws his protection from Peter, Satan will come into Peter, and then Satan will fall him. That is demand and request.
이것이 건강신학에 잘 이렇게 여러분 적용이 돼야 돼.
Now let's apply this to our biotheology. You know, I practice New Start. You know, I can get sick because, let's say, Satan. You know, God, let's say Satan. You know, let's say Satan talks to Jesus. You know, saying this says like New Start and blah blah, and then you know he got healthier and he looks like he's well. Preach, he talks and has a lot of seminars and so forth. Now my wife's brother-in-law loves meat and drinks, and he's such a wonderful businessman. You know, but when I got married to my wife, my wife's brother-in-law, he was very thin. And my wife's brother-in-law, as he sees me getting healthier, he asked me a question like, "How come you get healthier every time?" And he said, "Well, you say you believe in God. I think your God is so real and your faith is real because every year you look different." You know, my mom is the same case. My mother, she was very upset about me teaching this New Start. But because I look different every time, my mother started to listen to New Start seminar, and my mother decided to get baptized after 5 years. Actually, for 5 years, my mother really, really scolded me. She even threatened me. She says she's going to die. She says she will kill herself and things. She really tried her best to stop me teaching this New Start. My mother was very stressed, and I was very stressed as well. Every time my mother meets me at the airport, she scolded me and she really bothered me because I practice and teach New Start, she was very unhappy. She threatened me even. Anyways, I was at the airport and my mom met me, and at the airport we took a taxi, and my mom noticed that my hair has changed. Means my hair was very thin. My hair was very thin and it was very weak. But then I got healthier, and then my hair got thicker and then shiny. And then she said that, looking at your hair, maybe what you're doing is, maybe that's something. So after all those 5 years, She never asked me where I have this seminar, but then that night, she asked me where I have the seminar she wanted to attend. You know, I had this Mercedes and nice house and everything. I was very rich, but because I practiced New Start, I gave up everything. So my mom was very upset about that and very unhappy about what I am doing. But even though I have this Mercedes, my hair was really thin and bad. But even though I don't have Mercedes with me, my skin, my hair, it's changed. Now, because my mom was very stressed, she had different forms of disease because she, you know, hated me and, you know, she was very upset. Anyways, she came to my seminar for 3 days and she said, well, have a seat. I'm going to apologize what I have done to you these last 5 years. You are a revolutionary, my son. Revolutionaries, they can't make money. But I see now your health has changed. That's also a revolution. That revolution, I pray, I hope that that revolution happens to my body as well. I won't worry about you anymore. Well, do what you're doing. Enjoy your job. And she decided to get baptized after that. After she got baptized, her illness all disappeared. She practiced New Start after that. Now she's about 90 years old. She has no illness. Well, she has a little bit of dementia. She's losing her memory slowly, but she has no biological sickness. By the way, my brother-in-law, the great businessman, he had diabetes, so I told him exercise and eat brown rice. So his diabetes is gone. He got better. Now he started to change just a little bit, and little by little he started to change. He quit drinking, he quit smoking, and then his diet has changed, and he didn't meet his like friends. Not the whole friends, but the friends that he enjoys those worldly life. And he said, I want to get baptized, he said. And you know, my brother-in-law, he's a business person, and he, you know, likes to stay where a lot of people are. And he said also, but he said that, you know what, I really want to go to a very quiet place and pray. I think I am crazy. And now this, my brother-in-law, he said, well, I want to do something for God with the money I have. You know, he was such a snob before. He was very... He was such a problem solver. He knew everybody. He knew what he was doing. But now he's a totally different person. He said, I'll build you this new center, New Start Center. He's a now totally different person. Do you think I explain academic theology to him? Do you think I could explain the theology to my mom? How can I explain the power, the work of Jesus Christ? You know, those people don't know God. Even sometimes they hate God.
인프라 뉴스타트 으로 말 한마디 안 하고 혁명이 느껴지죠.
You know, this new start, even though you don't mention about theology, but because of the infrastructure and all those things, you can make the revolution as well. It's about time. Time is coming.
그래서 이제 천국, 아, 예. 그래서 이제 이상구는 그런 사람이다, 알겠죠? 이제 완벽한 뉴스타트.
Now let's go back to the story. Now let's say, you know, I practice new start thoroughly. I can't get sick. You know, a lot of people look at me and they practice new start as well. Oh, look at Sang Lee. He's healthy and let's practice new start. So then, no, Satan. To fall many people, Satan is going to use Sang Lee. No, Sang Lee, Satan really wants to tempt Sang Lee, but then Sang Lee is not going to be tempted by me. So Satan says, well, I'm going to request Sang Lee, demand Sang Lee, God, draw your hand off me so that I can tempt him. You know, and then, you know, let's say when God's hands are off from me, then I'll get sick. And I will say, maybe, you know, God, I have been very dedicated and I have been doing this and that for you and so forth. But then I got cancer. What happened, God? I did all this to you. If I say this and if I deny God, that's what Satan wants. But Jesus, he doesn't want me to say like this way. I think this is the Abraham's experience. Like God said, offer Isaac. No, Abraham will say, I think Abraham was also requested by Satan. Satan wanted Abraham to deny God. But God, he trusted Abraham. Abraham is strong and he has solid faith. Even though he's tempted, he won't be like that. Who was shaken? Isaac. From the downstairs, I mean from the down bottom of the mountain, Abraham was not shaken. Why? Because Abraham said, we will come back. He used this future tense. It's not I will come back. He said, we will come back. So Abraham was not shaken. So I thought, yeah, that's the truth. Abraham knew that he was demanded. Abraham knew that God won't ask me to give my son to him. So Abraham, he thought, hey, I'm going to give my God victory. So Abraham said, we will come back. I'm sure the angels were all happy. But Isaac was shaken, by the way. Isaac said, we have fire and we have wood. Where is the offering? Isaac asked. Abraham said, God will provide. That's the faith of Abraham. He knew that his son cannot be the offering. He believed that. He believed Jesus Christ is the offering, not my son. It's not the salvation for righteousness by work. But now I'm caught in this demanding process. Abraham knew that if I don't turn away from God, God will give him what he has prepared. Abraham believed that God had prepared already. And that's why Abraham said, we will come back and God provides. That's the righteousness by faith. We think, okay, God told me to offer Isaac. Okay, I'm going to offer Isaac. It's like, because God says so, I will do it. It's like the righteousness by work. Now, they went up to the mountain, and I think Abraham explained it to Isaac. Isaac, Satan requested our faith. We have to give God victory. But we know that God won't want you from me. Maybe you will die, but I won't turn away from God. Even though you die, remember, you are not the offering. Jesus Christ is the offering. Even though you die, don't be angry. Let's give him victory. Isaac said, okay, Dad. Isn't that amazing? That's the righteousness by faith. Abraham, he took the knife, but he knew that he's not going to be saved by offering his son. And then God said, that's enough. Stop there. And they found that goat. And then Abraham said, see, remember, God provided this offering, and that's Jesus Christ. On that day, Abraham and Isaac, they met Jesus. I saw it. Abraham met Jesus at that time. I need to have that. I need to be ready for that. Actually, it happened to me many times. If I tell you all this, they're all very horrible. If you have no faith in God, if I had no faith in God, everything was very miserable. The things that happened to my kids was all horrible. When God withdraws his hand, death wave will come and you get sick. There's no protection, so life, death wave will come and you will have cancer. And then you have to know, this is request, this is demand from Satan. Then you say, God, I'm sure you're hurt. I'm sure you're hurt. But God, please help me not to deny you. And I'm sure God will help me on that. Let's say I die because of cancer. Even though he died, he was happy in God. But those who haven't experienced this kind of spiritual experience, they will just say, well, Sang-li, he died. Well, so Sang-li is just anybody, can be anybody. But let's say if I say, okay, those media staffs, please come and take. We'll tape what I do and how I do and how I don't deny God. If they see this peace and love from me, some people will say, well, that's New Start. Even though he dies, he doesn't deny God. That is true New Start. So Satan is actually struggling, let's say. It's not just me. All of you are in that scene. You are in that struggle right now. You know, Satan wants to consume each of our soul. You know, Apostle Paul, he had a great faith. He received that very powerful life wave.
Second Corinthians chapter 12.
He said, I was given a thorn in my flesh. That thorn is the messenger from Satan to torment me and keep me from becoming proud. Here the thorn in my flesh is the messenger from Satan. And we think this thing is, here the thorn, we think it's the eye problem, but if you look at 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 9, and he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities. Because His grace is sufficient, therefore, I will rather glory in my infirmities. What does that mean, infirmity? Infirmity means sickness, infirmities, my illnesses. Plural, singular, plural. Yes, eye problems can be included, but here, Apostle Paul, he knew that he is a sinner. Apostle Paul, before, when he was Saul, he stoned Stephen. His character must be very hot-tempered person. So probably he might have several illnesses, before the character. It's not just about the I problem, but the character problems. Peter, Apostle Paul prayed to take all these out. But even so, you know, I experienced the grace of Jesus. You know, those illnesses, those thorns, they're from Satan. God, but then God is not going to pluck them away. Why? You know, Paul prayed three times. But if God doesn't take them away, then Paul, what? Satan said, if you don't take them away from Paul, then he will turn away from you. Then God said, no, he won't turn away from me. Even though I don't take those thorns away from him, he won't turn away from me. That's what the Paul says here. I will rather glory in his infirmities. So those people who come to my center, you know, there's some patients. Yes, there are some patients who get well, but some patients, they don't get well. And I say, yes, you will surely get healed. But remember, Satan is there. Satan wants to disconnect the relationship with you and God. It's not God is not almighty, but because Satan is trying to try your relationship with God. But remember, we have heaven with God. So don't turn away from God. Don't break the relationship. It's just because you don't get healed. You know, some people will say, well, Sangni said New Start. If you practice New Start, everybody will get, you know, well. But some people die. Why is that? They say this. But, you know, so this is not all. You have to always remember this spiritual war over the souls. I pray that New Start is very, the definition of New Start is very clear to you. You know, New Start is the infrastructure. The spirit, the energy in the Word of God, and the infrastructure should be equipped with that life energy. Without this, Alpha Course or G12, that kind of movement and course, you know, that course or the movement is all developed by all the very popular or famous theologists. So you can drink, you can smoke. You'll see, you will experience something. They use all the false spirit. Actually, in the church, those kind of false spirit power is all working. If you type Alpha Course, Peter Wagner, by Peter Wagner, you will see it's all happening right now. They're all Fuller theologian. Peter Wagner is a, yeah, is quite a figure. He's retired, but he developed this Alpha Course, and he's sweeping all around. This is just a part of the ecumenical movement and the church. This is for the one world religion. He's working for the one world religion. Those whole spiritualistic things are all around. Ellen G. White already prophesied this in the Spirit of Prophecy. Tomorrow will prove with the Spirit of Prophecy tomorrow. Let us pray. Dear loving Lord, through through your prophet, we have this biotheology. We thought biology has nothing to do with theology, so we didn't even try to understand this biology and theology together. Father, these people are the leaders of this remnant church. Please bless them and be with them. Please send your Holy Spirit to understand this. The work of Holy Spirit, help us to prove this truth. Please train us and mature us. Help us. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.